1922 that the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto was founded. However, up until that time, between 1900 and about 1915 to 1919, approximately 100 Maltese families could be found living at the Dundas and Macau location. The two churches you've just seen, Our Lady of Mount Carmel and St. Patrick's Church, were first used by these Maltese to hold their social events. And in 1925, 3 years after the Maltese Canadian Society was founded, the members of the Maltese Canadian Society participated in the procession of the Holy Name Society at St. Patrick's Church. There are still quite a few Maltese families still living in this area. Mind you, up until 1950, the majority of Maltese living down in this area had moved to West Toronto Junction, where the community is found at the present time. There is still one family who go to Mass here every morning. The family name is De Batista, and they live on Henry Street. A few years ago, I had the opportunity of interviewing Mr. De Batista on the events of the Maltese community, and this information now is in the Archives of Ontario. One advantage the Maltese had in using St. Patrick's was a Father Odd, who was of Syrian descent and could understand the Maltese language, which is of a Semitic tongue. During this time, in the early 20s, a Father Alphonse Kauki from the U.S. was visiting the Maltese community here in the area, and through his instigation, encouraged the Maltese to form into one group. And this is where, in 1922, the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto was founded.
Augustinian friar Father Alphonse Kauki was the instigator and unifying factor in helping to found the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto in September 1922. The Society's founders, Anthony de Batiste, Emmanuel Borge, Joseph Facello Sr., John Zamit, who is seated, and absent from the picture is Mr. Anthony Shakluna. To run properly, it is necessary to have formulated rules and regulations. The Society's first constitution was drawn up in 1927 on the Society's fifth anniversary. 40 years later, in 1967, it was officially revised during Canada's centennial year. The first St. Paul the Apostle Church was erected in 1930. The hardships of the early Maltese, along with the personal sacrifices made by Father Kauki, will long be remembered. The small basement church was literally built by the community, brick by brick. Domes and towers were to be added later. However, because of the large increase of the Maltese population in the 1950s, a newer church was built. This is a photo of the interior of the old church during an early wedding ceremony. is representational of Our Lady. The year is 1931. Dress their offspring in their best attire for the happy occasion. A small reception followed the service in the church. Proudly seated amongst his first Holy Communion class is Father Kauki and his assistants. Until his death in 1942, Father Kauki was St. Paul's first pastor, as well as being the diligent and dedicated spiritual leader of the early Maltese community in Toronto. Society, from its early beginnings, had always been interested in preserving the cultural background of the motherland. Plays, called teatrini, were performed in the old hall which had been built adjacent to the old church. During Toronto's centennial year, 1834 to 1934, the society entered a historical float in a parade which was being held in Toronto. Various community workers dressed in various costumes depicting the Sovereign Order of St. John of Jerusalem, or as they are also known, Knights of Malta. The order stayed in Malta for over 250 years. It was during this time that the islands reached their cultural, artistic, and architectural peaks, while at the same time becoming one of the main naval forces in the Mediterranean Sea. These two children of members were costumed to represent Britannia and Melita. Malta was a British colony until independence in 1964. Melita is the biblical name of Malta. This was a special committee, appropriately named Knights of Malta, set up by the society to organize the 1934 float. The float had won first prize in Toronto's Centennial Parade. The trophy is now found in St. Paul the Apostle Convent at 3224 Dundas Street West in Toronto. This is the original banner of the society. It's over 50 years old. Before the George Cross was added in 1942, the banner was comprised of a white and red flag, with a Maltese cross in the center. It wasn't always work and no play for the early Maltese settlers in Toronto. Here we see Father Kauki and some members posing for a photo during a picnic on Center Island. He also organized visits to popular shrines, for example, Martyr's Shrine in Midland, and various other types of recreational trips. Maltese, known for their love of color and pageantry, utilized every occasion that was possible to exhibit some of the history and culture of their place of birth. During the 1940 Labor Day Parade in Toronto, this was the float that was entered by the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto. In later years, carnival dances with fully costumed groups participated in the Society's dance evenings. In 1949, a photo appeared in the now-defunct Toronto Telegram showing some Maltese carnival revelers. Maltese dance called Il Parata was used to usher in the carnival in Malta. The Parata is an ancient Maltese sword dance in commemoration of the Maltese victory over the Turks in 1565, Malta's first great siege. Traditionally, the dance consists of a group of young men in colorful ribbons and brandishing wooden swords formed into two circles, representing the Turks and Christians. At the conclusion of the dance, a young girl representing Malta is carried shoulder high as a sign of victory. During its second great siege of 1942, under constant bombardment from the opposing factors for many months, and without the necessities of life, it did not surrender. Had Malta fallen, the course of history in 1565 and 1942 would have been changed. Enemy planes during all hours and the destruction they left made life on the islands extremely difficult and dangerous. Many families, especially from around the Grand Harbor, the Three Cities area, and as well as Sliema, left their homes for smaller villages and Gozo for more safety. Thankful occasion when one of the many food and supplies convoys were able to make it through enemy lines. One of the most famous convoys was the Santa Maria convoy, one old tanker which miraculously made it to the Grand Harbor after many hits was the famous Ohio. Malta Relief Fund was set up by Chevalier Edward Dublay in the United States to collect funds and supplies for beleaguered Malta during the Second World War. The Canadian branch of this was looked after by Mr. Angelo Cutayar, president of the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto. Thank you. Maltese, members of the Maltese Canadian Society and members of the Detroit Maltese Club met in Old St. Paul's Hall to celebrate the September 8th celebrations in 1945. Amongst the many people shown are some of Toronto's earliest Maltese settlers, former presidents and committee members of the society, as well as Father Vincent O'Neill, who replaced Father Alphonse Cauchy as pastor at St. Paul's. The society's old flag can be seen in the background. Significant dates in Maltese history is the celebration of the 1565 victory over the Turks and the second siege of 1942. The society celebrated these two important dates with a mass in St. Paul's and usually afterwards with a social dance. In this photo we see President A. Cotillard, Mr. Paul Falzon, who has been an active member since 1927, founder Anthony de Batiste, and Mr. John Zamit, affectionately known as Il Gudra. He's seen in the background. This photo was taken in the early 1950s. It shows the pastor of St. Paul's, Father Lawrence Bonavilla, President Angelo Cotillard and his committee. Father Bonavilla was the main impetus in having the new church erected with financial and administrative assistance from the society. Church was to be renovated into a larger building with domes and towers. However, because of the large influx of immigrants after the Second World War and the cost of such a project, a more modernized version was decided upon, and on a much larger scale.
Oh.
understood the large role played by the Maltese Canadian Society in the erection of the old St. Paul's and the new edifice, the name of the club was engraved, along with other benefactors, which were also society members, in the foyer of the new building on a stone tablet. The cornerstone of the new St. Paul's was laid in 1955, and within a record time, the convents and two auditoriums were built. The latter were erected in 1960 in commemoration of the 1900th anniversary of St. Paul's shipwreck on Malta. The whole complex was paid off in record time. The crest shown on the outside of St. Paul's Auditorium is that of a maple leaf, and on the other side, the Maltese cross. The crest of the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto is that of a maple leaf with a Maltese cross superimposed in the center of it. Meat, or as I mentioned earlier, known throughout the community as Il Gudra. He worked diligently for the church and the society for many years, and as well for the club. For many years, the club was known as Il Gazinta Knisia, or the club of the church. In appreciation for his many years of untiring service to his church, the Franciscans presented Mr. Zammit with a special scroll, giving him semi-clerical honors. Mr. Zammit passed away in 1969. President Angelo Cutayar. Over a period of many years, he served as president of the society, totaling a number of 17 years. Mr. Charles Baldacchin will long be remembered for his many teatrini and other events he organized for the society. He was president in 1950. President Frank Grech was president from 1956 to 1957. He was followed by President Charles Day Doon from 1957 to 1958. The president of the society during its 40th anniversary was Knight Commander Frank Savona. He is shown here along with Father Bonavilla and the committee. A special 40th anniversary celebration was held by the committee in St. Paul's Hall following a mass. President Savona brought into existence the Life Membership Award, also in 1962. For five dedicated years, the society was served by President Knight Commander Frank Savona, and for an interim period of 6 months by President Alfred Fenech. President Savona was the first president to officially receive the Malta Day proclamation from Toronto City Hall. Also the first Miss Malta pageant, which was held in 1967, organized by the whole community as part of Canada's centennial. One of the youngest members ever elected as president was Mr. Frank Vitolero. Shortly after leaving society, he entered the priesthood and now serves the Christian community as a Jesuit priest. For an interim period of 6 months, the society was served by President Alfred Fenech. President Chevalier John R. Cordina served the society from 1966 to 1972. During this period, the society saw many major administrative improvements. The society's first official Miss Malta pageant was organized by President Cordina in 1968. As in past years, the society celebrated the Malta Day celebrations. Maltese Canadian Society's first Miss Malta pageant took place in 1968 in the Flamingo Banquet Hall above the club, which is decorated with Maltese mural paintings. The distinguished patrons for that year were His Worship and Mrs. William Dennison, Mayor of Toronto, represented by Controller Margaret Campbell. The 1968 winner was Miss Margaret Tonna. The previous year winner, in 1967, was Miss Joyce McAuliffe. Up until 1968, the committee and members met in individuals' homes or the church hall. Due to the advancement of the society in that year, the club acquired rented premises in the basement of Stellini's travel agency. Present at the ribbon-cutting ceremony were Alderman Bengris, Mr. and Mrs. Grazio Borge, Mrs. Catherine Vassello, wife of the founder, and her son Joseph Vassello Jr., as well as the president and other members. In 1969, the society required larger premises. Therefore, they rented the basement hall of the Flamingo Banquet Hall at 3278 Dundas Street West. Charitable works of the organization were dedicated to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. The devotion to the Sacred Heart is very popular in Malta. Colorful and historical culture of Malta, the Society participated in the first Easter Around the World exhibit in Toronto, organized by the Community Folk Arts Council of Toronto. Mr. John Camilleri and Miss Jane Gauci wore traditional Maltese costumes. They were congratulated by politician John Yaremko. Junior band during the 1940s. In 1969, a large marching band under the direction of Maestro Paul Gauci was formed. The band became very popular. In 1971, the band branched out on its own and renamed itself the Malta Band Club, which now has become a very important community organization within the community. Malta for 1969 was Miss Miriam Camilleri. The distinguished patron was the Honorable and Mrs. Paul Hellyer. Monica Scanura won the 1970 Miss Malta title. The distinguished patron was the Honorable Robert Stanbury, MP. Jubilant Donna Rossi won the title of Miss Malta in 1971. At that time, it was still being called the Miss Malta of Toronto Beauty Pageant. Senator Paul Martin was a distinguished patron. In first event to celebrate the Society's 50th anniversary was a ribbon-cutting ceremony and extensive displays at Towers of High Park at 2290 Dundas Street West. President Cordina, Franciscan Provincial Father Portelli, and Assistant Manager Mr. Paul Pauli officially opened the displays. Ms. Sandra Zarb and Ms. Josephine Cumbo held the ribbon. The various departments in the store decorated their aisles in Maltese colors of white and red, and the Society presented a trophy to the best display department. In the 1940s, and probably earlier, the Maltese Canadian Society held a carnival celebration. This is a more recent photo in the club with fully costumed groups. The 50th anniversary of the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto took place in 1972 after a great amount of preparation by President Alfred Goggi, the Public Relations Director, and the committee. President Goggi and his family had been members of the club for many years. During the 1972 Multinational Day celebrations, with Morton Schulman, MPP, the Maltese Cubs, and Maltese girls dressed in their costumes. A large anniversary dinner dance was held at Mimico Arena with many prominent guests present, as well as former President Knight Commander Frank Savona. The Maltese organizations of Southern Ontario and especially Toronto took part in a large and colorful anniversary parade honoring the Society on its 50th year. Afterwards, a large concert took place at Riding Park, with the Maltese group Grand Harbor performing along with singer from Malta, Monica McAuliffe. During the large and successful anniversary dance at Mimico Arena, five presidents of other Maltese clubs in Toronto posed for this historical picture with President Alfred Goggi. They were Mr. Joe McAuliffe, Mr. Eddie McAuliffe, Mr. Tony Kaleya, Mr. Henry Gauchi, and Mr. John Shibaras. Also present was Miss Malta for 1972, Miss Jane Simiana. The Society's 50th anniversary committee was President Alfred Goggi, Vice President Louis Borge, General Secretary Frank Camilleri, Corresponding Secretary Richard Cumbo, Recording Secretary Mrs. Josephine Mitzi, Treasurer Mr. Espedito Falson, Assistant Treasurer Mr. Charles Portelli. The directors were Mr. Paul Falson, Mr. Robbie Coutayer, Mr. Paul Stavala, and Mr. Paul Spagnol. The spiritual director was Father E. Lewis of St. Paul's Church. The society had received a new flag from the Vasello brothers, Joe and Laurie. Their father, Joseph, had been one of the founders of the club in 1922. Recipient of the Miss Malta of Toronto pageant for 1973 was Miss Diane Spiteri. The distinguished patrons was His Worship and Mrs. David Crombie, Mayor of Toronto, represented by Alderman William Boychuk. Miss Karen Gallia won the Miss Malta title for 1974. Minister of State, the Honorable and Mrs. Stanley Hydas were distinguished patrons. After spending nearly 8 months of chronologically filing and sorting through the Society's records, the documents were presented to the Public Archives of Canada as a permanent record. It was afterwards that duplicates were also presented to the Ontario Archives and the Multicultural History Society of Ontario. Up until this point in time, the Society had always organized the Malta National Day activities in Toronto on behalf of the whole Maltese community. After many deliberations, it was decided by the Society's committee that the whole community should be involved in this event. Therefore, a special meeting took place and a Malta Day committee with representatives from all of Toronto's Maltese clubs was formed. This later had grown into the Maltese Organizations Committee. After the resignation of President Alfred Goggi in 1975, Mr. Andrew Vasello became the president. During a two-month interval, Richard Cumbo acted as interim president. President Vasello, along with Miss Malta for 1975, Sina Aquilina, and Miss Pauline Sapiano, opened the Society's library. Work on this project had been started by President Goggi. The cabinets were handmade by life member Paul Mitzi. The distinguished patrons for the 1975 pageant had been the Honorable and Mrs. Robert Welch, Minister of Culture and Recreation. Miss Malta for 1976-1977 was Miss Rose Bonello. The Society was then under the presidency of Mr. Charles Aquilina. The Society was in a very low ebb, and it was decided to have the annual elections in February 1977. Mr. Robert Coutayer was elected president. However, in April of the same year, another general election took place and Mr. Alfred Goggi became the president. With the diligent work and support of the members and President Alfred Goggi, Mr. Robert Coutayer, and Mr. Richard Cumbo, the revitalization of the society took place. Once again, the Miss Malta pageant was held in the proper fashion, and the winner for the 1978 pageant was Miss Janet Butters. The distinguished patrons were Dr. and Mrs. George Corey, Chairman of the Ontario Advisory Council on Multiculturalism. The first Maltese distinguished patrons for the Miss Malta pageant were Dr. and Mrs. G. Fiorini at the 1979 pageant. The winner that year was Miss Josette Bonello. CHIN radio owner Johnny Lombardi, represented by his son Leonard Lombardi and guest, were the distinguished patrons for the 1980 Miss Malta pageant. The young lady who won that year's title was Miss Jacqueline Borge.
In 1980, the Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto was one of the main organizations involved in getting this little parquet located at St. John's Place in Dundas Street West, the name of Malta Park. Correspondence had been exchanged between many organizations up until 1981, and in the beginning of 1981, the various Maltese organizations in the city of West Toronto became involved. And finally, this little park located in this part of the city was named Malta Park.
This is Miss Malta for 1976 to 1977, Rose Bonello. There was a slight mix-up of this photo because of the turmoil in the society in 1976. Miss Mary Bartolo won the Miss Malta pageant title in 1981. The new chairman of the Ontario Advisory Council on Multiculturalism, Mr. and Mrs. Yuri Shimko, were that year's distinguished patrons. The society, along with Toronto's other Maltese clubs, were invited to participate in the Toronto Historical Board's first heritage fair at Old Fort York. The society was the first Maltese participant that year. Alderman Ben Griss and Alderman William Boychuk are congratulating Miss Malta 1981, Mary Bartolo, on the excellent exhibit. The Maltese Organizations Committee became involved with Heritage Fair in 1982, with all clubs participating. On its 60th year, the Maltese Canadian Society was provincially incorporated by the law firm of Paul Zammit, Dash, and Semple, who gave their services on a volunteer basis. Represented the society at many of its 60th anniversary events was the winner of the 1982 Miss Malta pageant, Miss Antoinette Zammit. The distinguished patrons had been the Honorable and Mrs. Nicholas Leloup, Ontario Minister of Correctional Services. The society had also received a Wintario grant to assist in producing a 40-page 60th anniversary publication. The minister responsible was the Honorable Bruce McCaffrey. On November 27, 1982, over 600 people attended a combined Miss Malta 1983 pageant and 60th anniversary dance to celebrate this milestone in the society's history. The distinguished patron was His Worship and Mrs. Arthur Eggleton, Mayor of Toronto. The 60th anniversary committee was President Alfred Godji, Vice President Joseph Muscat, General Secretary Richard Cumbo, Treasurer Sam Falzon, who is absent from the photo, Assistant Treasurer Mario Muscat, Directors Paul De Battista, Paul Delia, John Gallia, Alfred Gallia, Joe Greck, and Mr. Paul Briffa. In these 60 minutes, we have shown you 60 years of the Society's history. The Maltese Canadian Society of Toronto is a non-profitable, charitable organization striving for the betterment of the Maltese community.